Hello friends, welcome to Global Tech Learn. In this video, we will practice a Power BI question related to import multiple JSON files. And the question is, you have a folder that contains 50 JSON files. You need to use Power BI desktop to make the data of the files available as a single data set. Which type of data source should you use? Which transformation should you perform? And we have to answer two questions. First question is, what data source type we should select? And there we have three options: folder, JSON, and text or CSV file. And the next question is, what transformation we have to apply? Under that we have four options. That is, option A, combine the files of the content column. Option B, delete the attribute column. Option C, delete the content column. Option D, expand the attribute column. So in this question, we can see we have to import multiple JSON files and we have to combine all the files data in a single table. So before practice this question in Power BI desktop, let's look at the other question that is similar to this, but that was asked in a different way in Power BI exam. And the second question is, you have folder that contains 50 JSON files. You need to use Power BI desktop to make the metadata of the files available as a single data set. The solution must not store the data of the JSON files. Which type of data source should you use? Which transformation should you perform? And under options, we have same options as the question 1. And in this question, the difference is the solution must not store the data of the JSON files. And we have to store just the metadata of the files. So that means from all the JSON files, we have to import only their metadata, not the underlying data available in the JSON files. So let's look at the data first. So here under data directory, I have JSON files available. Let's look at one file, how the data looks like. And here we can see, in this file, we have two attributes, ID and name. So that means we have one record in this file. In same way, in all the files, we have one record in same JSON structure. So now let's try to import these files in Power BI desktop. So here in Power BI, we have to import data from multiple JSON files. For that, we have to select the folder. So let's go to the new source. And then we have to select folder as we want to import multiple JSON files available in this folder. So let's click on connect. And let me provide the location and let's click on the OK. And here we can see we are getting list of all the JSON files from the directory path. And now we want to apply some transformation on those files to combine the underlying data in these files or the metadata. So let's click on the transform data. And over here we can see we are getting list of all the files, that is file 1, file 2, file 3 and so on. And with this we can see we are getting two columns, that is content, and second column is attributes. So we have to understand what are those columns. Attribute column is the column that holds all the metadata of all these files. So let's look at what are the columns we have under attributes. So when we click on the expand attribute column, we can see these are the all metadata fields related to the files, like what is the content type, kind, size, read only, hidden, all are the attributes related to the files. So if I click on the OK, now we can see we are getting all the metadata attributes of the files. So with this, we are able to get the metadata of the files. And as we don't want the data as per the question, so we can remove this column from the model. And in the another question, we have to store the underlying data of those files in Power BI desktop. So for that, let's remove these steps. And now over here, instead of attribute column that holds a metadata, now we need data. So for that, the data is stored in content column. So for that, we have to select the content column and we have to combine the files. So once we click on the combine the files, the Power BI query editor is going to pass the underlying JSONs for all these files and combine the data. So here we can see we are getting list of all the files and underline data values, like each file has one record. So we can see in file 1 there is a one record that has two columns, ID and name. Similarly, file 2 has one record, that is ID and name, and so on. So now let's go back to our question. And here in a question case is, we have to store the metadata of the files and we have to ignore the underlying data. So here under data source type, we can mark as folder as a data source type, as we require to import multiple files. And under transformation, we expand the attribute column to get all the metadata fields. And in second question, you have folder that contains 50 JSON file, and we have to store data of all these files. So there we selected folder as the data source type, and under transformation we clicked on the combine the files to combine underlying data of the files in one table. So option A is the correct answer.